It's your boy Hurt in the lab, Flipside Sounds. What's good, world? But now I got this little beat, man. I'm just gonna mix it down for y'all, man. Let y'all partake in the act of making these hits, man. You know how I do. And if you don't know, you will know. But yeah, this little beat, man, just listen to it. I ain't mix it down or nothing. I ain't did nothing to it. Got potential. It's a busy beat, you know what I'm saying? It's a very busy beat, you know. I like a lot of percussion and, you know, things of that nature, but we're just gonna jump in here, man. But usually, man, you know what I usually like to do, I like to get my kicks and my bass in order off the jump, because it takes up so much of my bandwidth. You know, I want to get that under control. So I got this 808 right here, way too loud. Yeah, way too loud. But I'm gonna get this in order. I'm gonna throw EQ on it and see what we got. See, it's hitting a lot of that 50 hertz. So that's that frequency that make you get a heart attack if you bump too loud, you know what I'm saying? But I'm just gonna cut some of this extra out, man. But I'm just gonna round it off a little bit. Start from there. And I got a sign right here, a bass. I need to get that in order in conjunction with my kick. So they're taking up a lot of the bandwidth on the end. And I need to get that, you know, everything needs its own room to breathe, you know what I'm saying? So that's what's going on right here. And remember that kick was taking up a lot of room, 50 hertz. So what I like to do, man, like, so I can give a little room, I like to cut right there. I want my kick to come through. You know what I'm saying? I just want this to situate. When I get to this point, when I mess with these two basses, man, I'll go back and forth and I'll figure out what I need to let go or let shine. I think I'm gonna let this kick shine through, cause you know how we like it in the South. We like a lot of bass heavy. I know I do anyway. Bass heavy tracks, you know. So what I'm gonna do? Kick is about 100, anywhere from 80 to 120, somewhere in there, you know what I'm saying? You just gotta find everyone's a little bit different. Every kick's a little bit different. So I'm gonna bring that kick out, the punch in that kick. And what I do, I like to boost and find where that frequency's coming through it right there. Yeah, that's about 108 right there. I like to. hood 200 a little bit. Now I'm with the mid-level compressor on, it's kind of just to control it a little bit, give it a little control to the, you know, so I'm gonna take about 3 decibels off with probably go 4-to-1 ratio on this one right here. I just want to control it a little bit. I don't want to do too much to it. And don't forget your gain reduction. It's very important. And what I'm doing here, I'm watching my meter and how it reacts with my release time. How much dynamic range I get from the top to where it peaks out to the baseline reading. I'm gonna roll with that right now. You know, these, I got them centered right down the middle. So you want your bass to be centered in the middle. And see, that's why I like to get that in order, because you know, with the other instruments and other, you know, the percussion or whatnot, you know, you can kind of find their own place with the pan pots, you know, where they need to be. But with the bass, you know, you really can't.